very warm welcome to chapel for tonight's service of lessons and carols. Our service will begin in 5 minutes, but before it does, just a few words of welcome to those joining us online. Very good to have you with us. There is an order of service which you can download from the school website, and there should be a link in the video description on YouTube to access that. I invite all at home and those here in this chapel to now enjoy listening to the organ voluntary as we pause for a moment's silence and prepare our hearts and minds to hear the Christmas message once again. It is our practice here in chapel to keep silence before the service begins.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to the Chapel of the Holy Child for tonight's service of lessons and carols, and a special warm welcome to those joining us on the live stream. I am so grateful tonight to the many whose preparations have gone before this service and special occasion in the life of our school, to the wonderful team of helpers for decking the chapel in floral finery, to Dr. Thomas and Mr. Scriven for rehearsing the choirs, and to all those who have made the live streaming of this event a possibility. Our retiring collection tonight will be in aid of justice and care, and details can be found on the rear page of the Order of Service. It's a brilliant organisation worth supporting. Do give generously if you are able. The service now continues with the bidding prayer and will then run without any further announcements as printed on the Orders of Service. Beloved in Christ, be it this Christmastide our care and delight to hear again the message of the angels, and in heart and mind to go even unto Bethlehem, and to see this thing which is come to pass, and a babe lying in a manger. Therefore, let us read and mark in Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purposes of God from the first days of our disobedience unto the glorious redemption brought us by this holy child. And let us make this chapel glad with our carols of praise. But first, let us pray for the needs of the whole world, for peace on earth and goodwill among all people, for unity and brotherhood within the church Christ came to build, and within this village of Cranleigh, and in this our school. And because this of all things would rejoice his heart, let us remember in his name the poor and helpless, the cold and the hungry, the exploited and the oppressed, the sick in body and in mind, and them that mourn, the isolated, lonely, and the unloved, the elderly and the little children, all those who know not the Lord Jesus, or who love him not, or who by sin have grieved his heart of love. Lastly, let us remember before God all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in a greater light, that multitude which no man can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom in the Lord Jesus we forevermore are one. These prayers and praises let us humbly offer up to the throne of heaven in the words which Christ himself has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. May the Almighty God bless us with his grace. Christ give us the joys of everlasting life, and unto the fellowship of the citizens above, may the King of angels bring us all. Amen.
God announces in the Garden of Eden that the seed of the woman shall crush the serpent's head. Then the man and his wife heard the sound of the Lord God as he was walking in the garden in the cool of the day, and they hid from the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid." And he said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree that I commanded you not to eat from?" The man said, "The woman you put here with me, she gave me some fruit from the tree, and I ate it." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent deceived me, and I ate." So the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you above all livestock and all wild animals. You will crawl on your belly, and you will eat dust all the days of your life, and I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between you, your offspring, and hers. He will crush your head, and you will strike his heel." Thanks be to God.
Christ's birth and kingdom are foretold by Isaiah. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land and of deep darkness, a light has dawned. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. The prophet foretells the glory of little Bethlehem. But you, Bethlehem, Ephrathah, though you are small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come for me one who will be ruler over Israel, whose origins are from of old, from ancient times. Therefore, Israel will be abandoned until the time when she who is in labor bears a son, and the rest of his brothers return to join the Israelites. He will stand and shepherd his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God, and they will live securely, for then his greatness will reach to the ends of the earth. Thanks be to God.
Joshua Bell is a violinist, but he is no ordinary violinist. He has won Grammy Awards, he is world-renowned, and if you want to go see him in concert, you'll need to part with hundreds of pounds. This is because he is a virtuoso in his field. He is without a doubt a total genius, and when you listen to Bell in concert, he plays on a priceless Stradivarius violin. One day, as an experiment, the American newspaper, The Washington Post, invited Mr. Bell to exchange his concert attire of white tie and tails for blue jeans and a baseball cap, and swap the bright lights of a grand concert hall for a dirty Washington, D.C. subway station. Instead of playing his music to an exclusive few, there in the subway, Bell displayed his incredible talent to anyone who passed by. In that subway, Bell busked some of music's most notoriously difficult pieces in the same way that he always does, to perfection. The Washington Post called this experiment a test of people's perceptions and priorities. You can watch the video to see what happened and read the articles to see how people responded. But the big question is this: did anyone pay attention? Would people perceive the presence of this man's greatness in the hustle and bustle of their daily commute? Would anyone stop to listen? Or would they just hurry on by, too busy, too distracted to even notice? And what of the result of this experiment? Well, after 43 minutes and six classical pieces performed, just seven people paused to listen. And only one person in that great crowd recognized him, and a whopping 1,097 people passed straight on by. Ironically, just 3 days before that experiment, Bell had played the very same pieces to a sellout concert where a single ticket cost over $100. But that morning in the subway station, his busking earned him a mere 32. So how did hundreds of people walk past without even realizing? How did something, someone so remarkable just pass them by? Well, I think they were rushing, too busy. And in the busyness of everyday life, people don't have time to consider the greatness that might be in front of them. What is true of those commuters can be true of us at Christmas time. You see, we've done it all before. It's the same each year. We go through the motions. We decorate the home. We wrap up the presents, cook the same meals, and attend the same school carol services. We know what to expect, don't we? The lights, the sparkles, the John Lewis advert, the decorations, the feasting, the presents, the tree, the traditions, the movie, and Michael Bublé playing on repeat. It's wonderful. And maybe not Michael Bublé, but it's wonderful. Those traditions are lovely. And we love it, don't we? But are we at risk at missing the main event? Are we too busy, too distracted in our routine and hurry that we miss the centerpiece of this whole season and miss someone truly great in our midst? At Christmas time, Christians around the world remember the presence of greatness that first Christmas, as God himself entered into this world in the form of a baby boy. There are no bright lights of a concert hall in the nativity story, nor a subway with many passers-by. But there is a King of Heaven who is born in a stable, who swaps the glory of heaven for the muck and the mess of this world. God's Son, Jesus, trading his divine tie and white tails, his honor, glory, and heavenly acclaim, for a life of humble beginnings in a stable, and ultimately a death on a cross. And so as we gather one final time in this chapel before the end of this year, I want to gently encourage you all. Don't make the same mistake as those commuters. Don't be in so much of a hurry when it comes to Christmas this year that you miss the main event and miss out on the most significant person who ever lived. God himself, who took on our likeness, the Word becoming flesh, who has made his dwelling among us, and lived, and died, and rose again, and now calls us to himself, that he might dwell in our hearts today. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. The angel salutes the Blessed Virgin Mary. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored, the Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I'm a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the only one to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she, who was said to be unable to conceive, is in her sixth month. For no word from God will ever fail." "I'm the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." The end, the angel left her. Thanks be to God.
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius, the governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and the line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them. Thanks be to God.
Shepherds are the first to hear of the remarkable birth. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Magi honor the King of the Jews. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me, so that I too may go and worship him." After they'd heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route. Thanks be to God.
St. John describes the arrival of God incarnate. "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. Praise to you, O Christ.
Let us pray. O God, who makes us glad with the yearly remembrance of the birth of your only Son, Jesus Christ, grant that as we joyfully receive him for our Redeemer, so we may with sure confidence behold him when he shall come to be our Judge, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end. Amen. Please would you stand for the blessing. May he who by his incarnation gathered into one things earthly and heavenly bestow upon you the fullness of inward peace and goodwill. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.